Welcome back. Thanks for watching again. So recent news, I moved in. So now she gets to deal with me.
She's here now. This room actually looks like a legitimate room now.
Yeah, so this is where we filmed our first video.
Yeah, our first one.
Our first video. And now it actually has furniture in it. A bed.
An actual bed.
Unfortunately, not a little London puppy running around.
Yeah, no, but not today, unfortunately.
One day.
One day we'll have an animal running around here. Okay, so what are we doing for this video?
For this video, we're doing roommate advice.
Yeah. So, I think we're going to be doing fun, casual videos and then advice videos. Hopefully, that will be the routine. And since Cassie just moved in, we thought we would do a roommate advice video. So we're gonna go through the different stages of a roommate as you get older, starting at college, ending to like our age right now, and kind of give our point of view, and you know, not necessarily super detailed stories because we don't wanna be mean, or but we'll give you our advice and the things we've learned from living with different types of roommates. Actually, I haven't heard your college roommate. Okay, so why don't we start with freshman year?
Okay. Well, freshman year, typically thrown in the dorm. Is it mandatory?
Yeah. Well, it's not mandatory, but usually thrown. We call it residence hall, the CFC, not the dorm.
No, we call it. we're not.
So you're thrown into a room with someone else, or multiple girls, or
yeah. How many did you have?
So we had a suite, so there were two girls, and the four of us shared a bathroom.
Okay. Ours was similar. It was two and two that shared a bathroom, and then we had a common area, and
yeah,
two and two that shared a bathroom. So eight of us in
one section. Yeah, one of those big ones. No, we had a common area, two bathroom between.
Yeah.
But some of our residence halls did have that style.
Some of them had, I think, it was four bedrooms, and each had their separate bedroom. That was actually a lot nicer. They had a little kitchen area.
But one of our residence halls had two and two and like a full-on kitchen and a bathroom to share that. Or no, only two of them shared a bathroom.
Okay.
A full-on kitchen.
Yeah.
It was a pretty awesome place.
That's the residence hall I did not ever go into because there were some bathrooms in there.
That's a return for you.
Oh gosh.
So your roommate freshman year.
We got along pretty well, for the most part.
Is there a reason why specifically y'all got along? Do you know? Do you have any advice for freshmen moving in?
I was going to say, I'm an awesome person.
Okay, wow. That's legitimate advice.
I think, if you go in with an open mindset, knowing that you're going to be put with somebody that is very different from you.
Yeah.
Like, ours was even a culture difference, but, you know, it was cool learning about her culture, she learned about mine. I mean, it wasn't until the end we were like,
My freshman year, I've had a horrible roommate choice. So my freshman year, I went in with the mindset, which never, ever, ever do this, with the mindset of we're going to be best friends.
Yeah.
You do not go into that thinking
that.
Don't expect that. You're going to find your friend group. They're going to find their friend group. And if y'all are close friends, lucky you, but don't expect it. So that was my first issue. The second issue was, I think we were too different, nor did we really communicate. There was really no communication, and she just had her own lifestyle, and I had my own lifestyle, and she was very territorial over stuff, though. Yeah. So that would be an issue. It wasn't like I was stealing anything, but she was just very territorial. So, and then she moved out, and then I got a new roommate, who I love. Like, I love her, but she stayed in the room the entire time.
Yeah.
Which is kind of a downside.
I never stayed in her room.
Really? My first one never did. She just like moved her stuff out one day and
And I'm like, okay, now we need to get on that level. I think the turning point with mine was when I came home one night and found her boyfriend sleeping in my bed, and I was like,
another advice, respect the other person's stuff.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, it's, don't expect them to allow you to taste something, use something, because people are different and they have their own opinions of their stuff. So just respect it. Respect their clothes, respect their furniture.
And if you're gonna have like a guy or a girl over, then be like, just give them a heads up. It's nice to give them a heads up.
Yes, and be respectful or respectful about that too.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it is your room, so you have a right to do that, but it's not cool.
It's just not the only one in the room.
Yeah, to bring a guy over, or a girl, or whoever over, significant other, and be involved in something that no one else should be seeing.
Yeah.
So be respectful about that, and don't do it every night. Because that's their room, yeah. I think that's my advice for freshman year.
Also, well, yeah, I learned that, but with every place, I've also learned that communication is very important.
Yes,
that is it easy to leave the passive aggressive notes, but try to be a little more confrontational. I'm speaking to myself here.
Yes, communication, the minute that ends, the minute everything ends.
Yeah.
You've got to not. One, you need to be able to say what you want to say, but two, you need to be able to not get offended by what someone else says. Like if she says, or they say, hey, you're leaving dirty dishes, can you please clean up? Don't be offended by that. Like,
yeah,
unless they're like blatantly insulting you, there's no need to be offended about anything.
Yeah, because you're going to run into your differences.
Exactly.
No matter who. So, yeah, you have to be able to say, if you don't mind,
exactly. Okay, the next one I would say is like later college years. So this is when you move off campus, and usually you have a choice of who you're living with. So mine, I lived with a total of three different girls. My best friend at the time, a close friend my junior year, and then a close friend my senior year. So for junior year, what should I learn? You gotta put your foot down. What I learned that year was my third roommate couldn't pay her rent. And she wanted us to pay it.
No.
And you're like, no. No, you have to
the
pay
money
it.
For that.
In the end, it worked out because we had another friend stay for the summer and paid half that rent and she was for the other half. And so in the end, it works out, but you can't just be like, oh, I guess we gotta pay it.
Yeah, you don't have to.
Well, it was a three-way contract. So all three of us were on the same contract. So if one of us messed up.
Oh, also, always sign a lease.
Oh, yes! I was gonna do that.
Oh, wait. That's
for later. But that's what I learned. And in this third time, my senior year is when communication started to drop. Oh, and be very, very respectful, of course, of other people's space.
Yeah, that's important.
Space, when they don't want to talk to you, they don't want to talk to you. Just let it happen. Let them have their own space.
And when I find my clothes in your room, when you did not get them, I wonder where you got them from.
Last year, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Sort of still good to go.
Yeah.
Okay. So, break time. Last
casual
Friday.
Break.
Send the cutest little video. Let me make sure I get
of my. This is Canyon. He's such a baby, except he sleeps really funny, and we were not sure if he can breathe, but he's sweet.
And that was my last roommate.
Okay, so
you're talking about college.
So I senior year.
Mm-hmm.
Also, please spring clean. Like every time there's a break, please clean. Because that will just make life a lot easier for you.
Yeah.
Because if you wait
until the
years, it's disgusting.
Yeah. I think we had an issue with cleaning. My sophomore year, I lived with two girls. And that whole, like, two's a company, three's a crowd, it's real. I was the crowd, apparently, until they started to get mad at each other. And then they both came and told all of their friends.
three of us, and we're girls, and I guess this is what we do, but like, we would gossip with each other about each other,
and it would get back to them.
We never did that. We were at least committed not to actually, and unless it was something like really absurd, we would not spread it within ourselves. Yeah, at least we had that. But it would be each of us gossiping about the other person. I mean, it's a way to vent, at least someone else in the household understands. The only issue with that is, out of those three girls, only two of them are friends with them right now. Yeah. Okay.
Wow.
Are you friends with any of them?
Oh, no.
Okay.
Well, actually, yeah, kind of, as in friends were cordial.
Yeah,
cordial.
As in,
your mom, my mom.
Yeah, like, she is overseas right now, so
we don't see each other, but
you're cordial.
We follow each other's, like, Facebooks and Instagrams and stuff.
Yeah, the other one blocked me.
That's okay.
Okay, so next situation. Our previous situations from right now.
Well, also,
what?
My last year of college, I just decided to live with my cat. That was a pretty good deal, too.
It was just you and your cat?
Yeah.
That's an awesome life.
Yeah.
Mom.
I know.
Oh, God.
I'm decorating my new room and my mom thinks I'm gonna spend less money.
Just. Okay. So living alone is fun.
It is. I was actually told from a lot of people that I would love living alone.
That's the same here.
And I didn't, exactly.
I mean, I liked it.
I liked having my space.
Yeah, it's peaceful, but then I got lonely.
I got very lonely.
That's what stinks, is like, as much as I love not socializing with people.
Well, I just love not having to clean up after other people.
Yeah, true.
My cat was a mess, though, so it was a clean up after the other
one. Yeah. But it got a little lonely.
For the short period, I lived alone.
Yeah. Okay. Previous situations? Okay, so I moved into another place with the third roommate from last time who was my best friend in college. The only issue is I hadn't ever lived with her without another person as like a buffer almost. And we came in here, so my parents owned this place, so she did sign a lease. I obviously don't sign a lease. So we came in here and it's a really nice place. And we were just so different. That's the issue. Like, she had a job, she was out in the real world, she had a big social life, and I was in school, and I was studying, and I was...
No social life.
No social life, basically. No. And she has a very outgoing personality, like, really, really, like, loud and excited, and I'm obviously not that. I have the opposite personality. And I think without that buffer, it got a little much, in the sense of... One, we lost communication, issue right there, we stopped communicating. Two, we just had different expectations for where we were living. I had the expectation of it being quiet, study area, clean, peaceful, and of course she had the idea of it being a social area, which she has the right to believe that because it's her place and she's out of the real world and blah blah blah, but it came to the point where I brought up the fact that next year I needed like a peaceful place to live and living together wouldn't work out well, and she didn't take well to it and drastically moved out in January, and until now has been living alone.
Yeah. Well, it's also like, you know, she should have her social time, but it should also be a quiet space, you know.
Yeah.
Like, hey, this is like I'm going to have people over schedule kind of thing. Like, I was fine with, like, my friends or my roommates throwing parties, just, you know, let me know, and they always did.
Yeah.
But, yeah, there's that respect and mutual understanding.
Yeah. So the minute that went downhill is when we stopped talking. So, my advice is make sure that you're aware of what the space, your expectation for the space is, then make sure you're constantly communicating.
Yeah.
Because our communication would be like, yeah. What your place?
So my previous situation was the first situation I've been in, which I haven't lived in a ton of places, but it was the first time that I actually really loved the people and really hated the place. Yeah. I lived downtown,
was not a safe place.
It was not safe.
It's near a street that's known to have shootings and just being
drug deals.
Like, it was just not a good area.
Yeah. So,
plus your place
it was not well lit either.
It was well lit. It wasn't really nice.
I would walk to my car at 6:30 in the morning when it's still dark and I would be like, okay,
yeah,
good. So, yeah, it was stressful. And then there was dust and bugs. And
well, if you, it's an old house, and many of the old houses,
it's not that it was dirty.
It was just old and you can't really deal with it.
And you can't get the dust to stop.
Yeah,
I don't know where it came from. And then also being downtown, not cockroaches, a lot of bugs.
Okay, if anybody knows the difference between a cockroach and palmetto bug, you'll understand how bad palmetto bugs are. Palmetto bugs are like
this big.
The whole Colgan of cockroaches.
Yeah.
They're huge.
And one crawled up beside me while I was studying, and I was like, oh Lord, I just realized my worst fear. So, yeah, it's nice to not have to deal with that now.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I loved the people. We got along really well. Obviously, I missed the puppy a lot that I lived with.
Yeah, it's so sweet.
I still go by and visit. But yeah. I guess my advice with that is look at the place before you move in. I kind of let my friend from high school that I was living with find it because I was living in Richmond and it was like a 6-hour drive and I didn't have time for that. So I was like, yeah, you find it. Good to go as long as I can have my cat. And I don't have my cat and it was also in a really bad place. So no matter what, try to look at the place.
Why do you think your roommate situation was so good?
I don't know. Nobody's really dramatic for the
maybe
most
that's,
part.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then we were also really good at just being like, hey, those dishes have been sitting there for a while. And we were also really good at like helping each other out with the cleaning. And so nobody ever felt like they were doing
all of it. Yeah.
And that was nice.
Yeah.
Communication.
It's always, it's so strange, like, well, I think one thing is growing up and realizing that you need to address an issue.
Yeah.
A lot of people go in and it's hard to bring up an issue, but if you address it early, then you'll be fine. Okay. So, party thoughts. Advice towards people going to live with a roommate for the first time. College
advice. I guess try, think of how, this is very cliche.
Yes.
But think about how you would want a roommate to act towards you. And then if you would like them to keep the dishes clean, you keep the dishes clean. And if you want them to sweep every week, you do that too. And that way, you know, even if I was in the kitchen doing some dishes, one of my other roommates would jump in and up the counter. And so if you put in your work, then they'll put in theirs. Mutuals. Being mutual with everything.
Yes. Mine would be, I guess, communication, of course. Always keep an open communication. Not a text message communication, but actually talking to each other. And second would be, don't take offense to everything. Because if you take offense, they're not going to want to talk to you. If
they're going to be afraid to talk to you.
Yeah, exactly. And then that's going to just ruin that communication. And be able to confront an issue.
Yeah, that's a big thing.
That's a huge thing. And then just be aware what you're going into. Like when you moved in, I was like, okay, this is my issue. This is what I want with this place.
Yeah, she was like, all right, the dishes. They need to stay washed. I was like, sweet.
The dishwasher needs to be run. In just general, just keep your expectations just plain and clear.
Yeah, and it is good to sit down when you first move in with somebody and be like, this is like my biggest pet peeve. Mm-hmm. Because if they know, then they can work through it. They don't have anything to do about it.
Exactly. So,
yeah. So that's it. That was our serious one. And wish her luck.
I think we'll be fine.
We'll be great.
Yeah. Okay, we'll see you next time.